Color plays an important role in your social media content. It can be used to grab attention, create different emotions, help with contrast and readability, and help you stay consistent and on brand. Plus, your audience will learn to recognize your content just by the colors that you use. And in this video, I'm going to share some Canva color hacks that you might not have known. My name is Kat. This is Canva Catter Day. Let's get to it. For our first color trick, we are going to work with some photos. I have an image right here, and I'm going to click Edit Photo and then Adjust. Here we have some different options for adjusting this photo. We can change the temperature, tint, brightness, contrast, and so on. But what you might not have known is that by default, Canva shows you the whole image area. But if you click on this box, you can choose to change the whole image, just the foreground, or just the background. So I'm going to click on background, and I'm going to go down where it says color, right down here, and I'm going to adjust the vibrance and saturation of this photo. So I will click on vibrance and drag that slider all the way down. I'm going to do the same with saturation, drag it all the way down. And just like that, I have created a color isolation image. That's when you have portions of the image that are black and white and the rest are in color. I can take it one step further. I can click on background and change it to foreground. And I can bring the vibrance up on the subject in the photo to help it pop just a little bit more. Let me show you another thing you can do with this. I'm going to click on this photo and I want to blur this background ever so slightly so that the subject image pops a little bit. So I'm going to click on Edit Photo, click Adjust again, and this time click on background. And this time I'm going to go down to where it says texture and I want to change the sharpness and the clarity for this image. So I'll drag the slider down. You can see it's blurred my image just a little bit. And then I'm also going to drag the clarity down. It blurs it a little bit more. And then I can click here and change the foreground. And I'll bring the sharpness up just a little in my subject. And I think I'll bring the vibrance up a little bit as well. And it just helps that pop a little bit more. So by using this select area option, you can choose exactly which portions of your photo that you want to change. For the next color hack, we are still going to work with the color editing options. So I have two additional photos here. I have a background image there and one there. I'll click on this first one, click Edit Photo. Again, I'm going to the Adjust tab, but this time I want to go down here to where it says Color Edit. So this option will allow me to adjust certain colors that are in the photo, and Canva will show you what those dominant colors happen to be. So I want to adjust this blue background and I want to change it to something else. So if I click on this blue option, I have additional options available to me. I can change hue, saturation, and brightness, and it will only affect the blue portions of this image. So let's say we don't want this background to be blue. Maybe you want it to be green. All I'm doing is dragging this hue slider into a different spot, and it's changing only that background portion for me. I can bring it the other direction. Maybe you want to change it to pink. So I'm going to make it pink right there. If I want, I can also adjust the saturation and the brightness a little bit and bring it up a little bit more. So let's just bring that saturation up a little like that. And now instead of a blue background, I have a pink background. So let's go the other direction. Here I have a pink background. And now let's change this to a blue background. So you'll notice when I click on the photo that the color edit options changed, and it's telling me now that the dominant color is this pink background. I'll click on this pink option. And once again, I can drag this hue slider. Here's purple. Here's blue. It'll go all the way through the different colors of the spectrum simply by dragging this hue slider into a different position. And then once again, I can bring up the saturation if I want to, or the brightness, or anything else within this section. I did a full breakdown on this color edit option in a different video. I'll put the link at the top. You can click on that and you can watch that at your leisure. And then while you're at it, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you can see more videos like this in the future. So let's move on to our next color trick. For this next color trick, you can take any Canva design and change the colors, and you don't have to do it one by one. You don't have to click each of these elements and change those separate colors. You can use Canva's built-in features to change them all at once. If you go up here to the Styles tab, you have additional choices. I can change them to match my brand color. So I can click on my brand color palette, and if I click these colors, it will cycle through different color options of my brand until I get to a choice that I really like. If you don't want to use those, you can also go down here to where you have combinations. You've got different color choices here. I can also go to some built-in color palettes in Canva and choose any of these color options. So let's do this one. It's changing those colors. I can click this box again, and it will continue to cycle through these color choices until I find one that I really like. So you can use this built-in feature to change all of the colors in your design at one time without having to do them one by one. For the next color trick, we're going to do something very similar to the last one. We're going to adjust the colors in this Canva design, but this time we're going to use color palettes from other sources. So if you go to Canva's own color palette section, you can pull colors from any of these predetermined palettes that are right here within Canva. You can also use some third-party websites. So right here we have colorkit.co. You can pull any of the colors in here. You would simply click on one of those color palettes and you can download this palette to your device as an image file. I can just click export and it will download it as a PNG to my computer. You can also use the website Color Hunt. It does the exact same thing. You pick any of the color palette choices and download that image to your computer. And there's also this fun website called Peloton, which I think is a really fun play on words. This one will allow you to make some really neat color choices. Not only does it change some colors and give you different palettes, it gives you different shades. It also tells you the hex codes of those shades. And then you can adjust from here and choose different color combinations for your color palettes, and then download those to your device and use those in your image as well. So once you've got your color palette choices downloaded, you just simply upload them back into Canva. Here you can see I have a whole bunch of different palettes that I've been playing around with. And I'm gonna click on one of these. Now these are just PNG images. I'm gonna click on one of these and bring it into my design. So here's the fun part. You wanna click on the three dots of that image. And down here you have where it says apply colors to page. When I click on this, it will do exactly that. It just changed that template with the exact same colors in the color palette that I chose. If I don't like that combination, I can cycle through it, click those three dots, and click apply colors again, and it will continue to cycle through the color changes until I find one the way I like it to be. So let's try a different one. Let's try this one. And I'm going to click three dots again, click apply colors to page. And there you go. You can keep doing this and keep cycling through the colors until you get it exactly how you want it to be. The next color trick is if you are using the free version of Canva and you don't have access to the Pro Brand Kit features, where you can upload your own fonts and colors to your brand kit, you can make your own brand color palette. So what I've done here is just added some of these colors that might work for a brand. Let me show you how I did that. I simply added a grid. I went to the Elements tab and went down here to Grids and found a grid that had six different sections. You can use whatever color combinations you want. If you only have four colors, you can use four, whatever works for you. And then I went and simply grabbed an image where I liked all of those colors, and I'm going to apply those colors to each one of the squares that I have here. So I'm just going to click on this first box, click on the color option, and Canva gives me color choices. It's pulling those colors, the suggestions, out of this photo for me. It's already doing half the work for me. So I will just choose each one of these colors and click each one of these boxes so that it fills each one with that color. Now I only have five here. I have six boxes, so I need one more. I'm going to click on that box. I'm going to go up here to the color option tool and choose the eyedropper and just pull one more color out like that. Maybe that blue. There we go. And then once that is done, you can delete this image. And here you have a custom color palette. Now you will just download this to your device and upload it right back into Canva, and it will work exactly the same way as it did in the previous example, where you add that photo to your design and you can then choose apply colors to page, and it will bring in that color palette for you. For the last color trick, we are still working with some Canva designs. And again, I want to alter these colors. So I'm going to click on my background image. I'm going to click on the color box. Going to click on add new color, and here is my eyedropper tool. You can use this eyedropper tool to pull any of the colors that are right down here within Canva. I can use any of these color choices here, and when I click on it, it will change my image. But did you know you can also pull colors from other images that you have on your computer? This is just a photo that's on the desktop of my computer, and I can click on this color box, click on the eyedropper, and not only can I pull colors from within Canva, when I drag the eyedropper over, look what it's doing. I can pull colors from this image. So I could bring in that color and it changes my Canva design. I can do this again. Let me go grab another color, maybe right here. Click on this color option, click on the eyedropper, and bring in something a little darker. Like that, I can go over here and do the same thing. Click on the color box, click on the eyedropper, and maybe pull one from like here. And you can continue to pull color from any photo that you have on your device. This is probably my favorite of all of the color tricks in Canva. Let me go use a different one. Here's another image. Once again, I'm gonna click on the background, click on that eyedropper, and then pull in one of those colors. Again, I'm gonna go up here, and this time I think I'll change the inner color right there. Click on that eyedropper and bring in maybe that color like that. And then again, continue to just use that eyedropper tool to bring in those colors from any photo that you want. Such a fun feature. I would love to know which of these color tricks you like the best and which ones kind of blew your mind. That's all for this week. I'll see you next time.